हेलो स्टूडेंट्स, होप यू आर हेल्दी एंड गुड। आई एम अर्शिया सैयद फ्रॉम राजीव गांधी इंग्लिश प्राइमरी एंड हाई स्कूल विच इज़ रनिंग अंडर पश्चिम महाराष्ट्र एजुकेशन ट्रस्ट। स्टूडेंट्स, इन माय लास्ट वीडियो वी हैड डिस्कसिंग अबाउट द चैप्टर रॉक्स एंड टाइप्स ऑफ रॉक्सेस, ओके, इन ज्योग्राफी क्लास 6th स्टैंडर्ड। ओके, सो स्टूडेंट्स, इन द लास्ट वीडियो वी हैड डिस्कसिंग द रॉक्स डेफिनेशंस अबाउट रॉक्स, टाइप्स ऑफ रॉक्सेस। इन टाइप्स ऑफ रॉक्सेस वी हैड डिस्कस्ड दैट what is igneous rocks, what is the example of igneous rocks, okay, sedimentary rocks, and the third one is the metamorphic rocks, okay. But in the last video we had only discussed about the igneous rocks in detail, okay. What are the igneous rocks? We just take a quick recap of that. What is igneous rocks, okay? Igneous rocks is the rocks which is made up of the molten material. Which is molten material? Which molten material is present in the igneous rocks? This is lava, the magma, okay, with the interruption of the interior of the earth crust, which is present on the interior of the earth surface, okay. This magma and lava, we are combined and form the after the process of the solidifying, they get formed a sediment, the first rocks, which type of rocks? The igneous rocks, okay. These igneous rocks are very much type. The best example of the igneous rocks is the basalt rocks, okay. These rocks are very much important. They are very hardness, they are homogeneous, they are very heavy, in that the properties of these rocks are very, they are present on the interior of the earth, okay. So so many things which is related to the igneous rocks is there, okay. But the next one is that which types of rocks? The sedimentary rocks, okay. So today we are going to discuss in detail about the sedimentary rocks, okay. This is the type of the rocks. So what is sedimentary rocks? You know, students, sediments means what? Okay, there are so many layers present in that. Okay, that's why they are known as the sediments. Okay, so sedimentary rocks are, the definition of the sedimentary rocks, rocks is defined as the rocks developed cracks. Okay, we see so many cracks in some rocks. Okay, the layers is there, the cracks is there. Why this is happened? This is the weathering of rocks. Okay, due to the disruption, due to the defrostations, due to the decomposition, disintegrations of the properties. So many properties which is related to the rocks. So many effects are present on the rocks. So these rocks develops cracks, okay. Sometimes they have cracks, sometimes weathering of rocks, okay. So this leads to the sedimentary rocks, okay. Sedimentary rocks develops cracks, water percolating through the rocks dissolves soluble minerals, okay. Whatever the substance, whatever minerals are present in the surfaces of the rocks, okay, they get dissolved due to the water discolation, water disruptions, okay. And water, what is that? The water percolating. Water percolating means what? Water they get touch and through down, touch and that they get far away, okay. So this condition from touching and far away, that movement is leads to the weathering of rocks, okay. That weathering and that cracks leads to the sedimentary rock. This is the simplest definition. This is a simple and the very clear concept about the sedimentary rocks. So these sedimentary rocks are the water percolating through the dissolved soluble minerals, okay. What weathering of rocks? Well, you know the weathering. Weathering means what? The layer is formed in the rocks, okay. This layer, why this layer is happened? Because of the weathering. What type of weathering? Water get percolating, water get continuously coming and touching down from upside, from downside. So this is the weathering of rocks, okay. So the main process, the how sedimentary rocks are formed, okay. Ki sedimentary rocks form kaise hoti, how it is formed, okay. Sedimentary rocks, first with the important thing is that, what is that? The rocks develops cracks. Ye jo rocks hote hai, whatever rock is there, they have a cracks. Second thing, weathering hoti hai, the weathering is occur. The third one is the disintegrated. Disintegrated means what? And decomposition means what? They get continuously decomposed, okay, in the soil. They get continuously decomposed from long and million and billion and year, they get decomposed in the soil. And the last one is the reduced to pieces, okay. Ye jo rocks hoti hai, whatever rocks they are guessed, first they are in cracks, second thing weathering is done, after weathering they get distinguished, they get decomposed, and after decomposition they get in the form or reduces in the form of small pieces, in the crystal forms, okay. So these forms, these types of rocks are there, reduces to pieces and transported by rivers. Where it is present, this type of sedimentary rocks, they are transported by rivers, glaciers, okay, and the so many areas they get present. Okay, they are in the sedimentary form. So they are in the sediment. They are in the sediment means what? They are in the layer forms. Okay, so this reduces to the pieces. First conditions kya hai? Whatever the conditions of the rocks is, first they get cracked. The second thing, weathering is occur. After weathering, they get distinguished, and distinguished, they get decomposed, and after decomposition, they get reduced into the small pieces. These small pieces is known as the sedimentary rocks. This is the simplest concept of the sedimentary rocks. Okay, now what are they doing? Due to the wind, transported by river, glacials, and the winds. Okay, where it is present? Rivers, glaciers, and the winds towards low-lying areas. Where it is present? In the low-lying areas. Another sir, deposited. Where it is deposited? They are deposited into the low-lying areas because they are present in a very pieces form. They are present in a very small number. Okay, one after the other. This is the process. Okay, how these sedimentary rocks are formed? These sedimentary rocks are formed due to different processes. First they get cracked, second they were weathering, after decomposition they get reduced into small pieces and transported to the rocks and glaciers and winds. And where it is present? It is present on the low-lying areas. So low-lying areas mein ye present hoti hai areas, and they get deposited. But how it is deposited? They are deposited into the one after other, and then after other. Likewise, this is the first layer, this is the second layer, this is the third layer, this is the fourth layer, this is the fifth layer. They get sedimented. Okay, they get sedimented. That's why it is known as the sedimentary rocks. They are present in the layer form. Okay, layer of sediments get deposited. Obviously, this is the first layer, they get deposited. Okay, and this is the second layer, they get deposited. This is the third layer. Okay, they get deposited. This is the fourth layer. So these are the sediments. Okay, these all are the layers. So obviously, ye layer jo rahengi, this is the last layer. This layer is very previous. This is very old. Okay, so these layer, first, second, third, fourth, and fifth, these all are the sediments of the layers. Okay, these sediments of the layer, that's why they are extracted and preserved from lost and so many and long year. Okay, so these are the heavy low lying areas. That's why they get formed sedimentary layer or sedimentary rocks. Okay, sea layers in the sediments, the layers in the what are the, we see the layers in sediments. Okay, we see so many layers. Okay, where the rocks get in the layery form. So jo bhi layer humko jo bhi rocks humko layery form mein dikhai denge, that layery rocks is known as the sedimentary rocks. And in the last video we had discussed that the what is igneous rocks. Igneous, no, we don't know about the where it is present fossils. We can't see the fossils in the igneous layer because they get not more old. Okay, but these sedimentary rocks are very old. Their lifespan is very high, they are million and billion year old, because the sediment get formed and decomposed, layer formed and decomposed. That's why it is very old layer. So we have seen fossils in these sedimentary rocks. We have seen so many fossils. Okay, we have seen so many fossils. So we have indicated as this is the sedimentary layer due to the presence of the fossils. Because fossils are, what is the fossils? Fossils, they are the impressions. Impressions, that's why it is known as the fossils. So presence of a heavy layer and sedimentary rocks. We see layers in the sediments in sedimentary rocks. So these all are the basic concept regarding sedimentary rocks. The definition, what are the properties of the sedimentary rocks, and sedimentary rocks have fossils because they are very old rocks. They have a very large and long layers in there. They get very million and billion layer formed. So now the second one is the layer get deposited, remain dead animals and plant get buried. Obviously fossils are, you know, the fossils, they are very old. They get show their impressions on the soil surfaces, in the rock surfaces. Okay, so that's why it is known as the fossils. Now come to the properties. What are the properties of the sedimentary rocks? Now see, first one is the brittle. Brittle means what? They are the very compact, very narrower. Okay, so that's why it is known as the brittle. Lightweight, ye jo soils hoti hai, ye jo rocks hoti hai, they are very light in where there is no high. What is the difference between the igneous rocks and sedimentary rocks? They both differences are there. Okay, sedimentary rocks are high light in weight, and the igneous rocks are, they are heavy and hard. Okay, so now the third one is the porous. Okay, what do you mean by porous? The rocks having holes in that. Okay, rocks having holes in that, but in not in all sedimentary rocks, but in some sedimentary rocks are porous are formed. These porous are due to the process, volcanic process is there. Okay, so some due to the volcanic processes the porous is formed. So these all are the three main properties of the sedimentary rocks. They are brittle, they are light in weight, and they are the porous. Some of them are having porous, but not in all sedimentary rocks, but in some rocks porous is formed. You know porous, porous is the dots are present or holes are present in the rocks. The best example of the sedimentary rocks is what is that? The example of the sedimentary rocks is the sandstone, limestone, coal, shale, corals. Okay, find coals in the this sedimentary rocks. Okay, you know coal. कोल हमको इस सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स के अंदर दिखाई देता है, बिकॉज कहते हैं ना वो द वन थॉट इज देयर कि कोयले में ही कोल इन द दिस सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स. तो दिस इज ऑल आर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द कोल, सॉरी प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ द सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स. ब्रिटल होता है, लाइट वेट होती है, पोरस होती है, एंड दे वी गेट फाइंड अ कोल इन द सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स. सो दिस इज ऑल आर द सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स. व्हाट आर द प्रॉपर्टीज, हाउ इट इज फॉर्म्ड, एंड व्हाट आर द प्रॉपर्टीज ऑफ दिस, एंड हाउ इट इज प्रेजेंट, एंड वेर इट इज प्रेजेंट, दैट दिस ऑल आर द थिंग्स विच इज रिलेटेड टू द सेडिमेंट्री रॉक्स. नाउ द लास्ट वन इज द मेटामॉर्फिक rocks. So in next video we are discussing in detail about the metamorphosis rocks is there. So in today's video we had discussed that sedimentary rocks, sedimentary rocks definitions, how it is occur, how it is formed, what are the constituents, what are the preserved materials, and how soil fossils is present in that, how we see fossils, and this is the properties or the what is the properties. They are brittle, lightweight, porous, and the example is that the sandstone, limestone, and corals. These all are the examples of the sedimentary rocks. Okay, so students, have you understood this all are the things which is related to the types of rocks? So if you like my video, please like and subscribe.